Babylon can't stop this campaign. Rampage, cause I know why the heathen rage. Cause the guys be bringing it out. This kingdom, we bringing it down. Lost sheep, we'd have been found. Wait until we get a crown. Crown talk, just that crown talk. Nehemiah don't want to be like Nino Brown now. Cause this that king talk. Real life king talk. Like Solomon, I see things clearly like a greenhouse. The wordplay can't get colorful. The scriptures cutting you the butter too. Not to mention we a living legend. Don't know what to do when a myth is standing right in front of you. You better watch and just take notes. The Father sent the flood, then a rainbow. But his son coming back with fire. So it ain't gonna be no more scapegoats. Let me tell you what the prophecy. Unparalleled with the prophecies. Stopping frisk, bodies in the street. My people property in this monopoly. Call it America, where the dreams come true. When nightmares and the demons come too. The sodomite agenda. I don't give a damn if you offended. Cause this-
Sirach chapter 6 and verse 32 for this.
Bring it up.
Let me give you something. I'm gonna show you something real quick. Because this is the truth. You understand you're an Israelite, right? Those curses that we read, that only happened to us. You is not no African American. You from the tribe of Judah. You understand that? You are God's praise, sis. It's time for us to start living like it. Read. This is the book of Sirach, chapter 6 and verse 32. Watch what God say. God saying it's you, you and me, and all our brothers and sisters that's under our voice. God saying this to us. Read. My son, if thou wilt, thou shalt be taught. God said, if you got a willing mind, you'll be taught. The God will send you to the right people. Like you came up here real humble. You had questions. God will deal with. Same with you. If God will lead you to the people that got the answers if you truly want them. Read.
And if thou wilt apply thou mind,
read,
thou shalt be prudent.
That means wise. God will give you wisdom. So how do you get wisdom? Psalms 111:10. Watch
this.
Let me show you how to get wisdom, sis and brother. This is how you get wisdom right here. God gonna give you the wisdom. Watch this. Read.
This is the book of Psalms.
The Bible. Watch this, sister.
Chapter 111 and verse 10.
Read.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
You know what that? I want you to hear this. You know what that's just say? You know what God just said? He said, when you fear Him, that's when you get wisdom. When you fear God, that's when your wisdom comes. I give you an example. How you doing? I give you an example. You got kids, right? Your kids stick something in the outlet and get shot. You say, don't you ever stick no scissors in there. Your son or daughter say, you know what? Mama ain't here. Give me that scissors. I want to see what that's really about. Right. Stick it in there.
There you go.
Do they ever do it again?
No, they ain't going to do it.
But they had to learn the fear of the Lord. They had to learn that, oh, if I do this, I'll die. Let me not do this. It's the same way with God.
Right.
God said, look, if you do this, you will die.
Right.
Don't do that so you won't have to die. That's what God's saying. He don't want none of his children to die.
Right.
We choose death. We the ones say, you know what, God? No, she might have it, but if I go in strapped, I might be all right. You know, or he does have a wife, but he just so handsome to me. That's what some sisters say. He looks so good. I know God wouldn't make nothing that look that good because I know a black man look good. You know we look good. It is what it is, right? So, but God is saying if he's off limits, if he's already married or he is already with someone, the Bible says stay away.
Right.
But we say, I can't stay away. My body is yearning. And then we end up doing it, and then we end up with an STD. Oh, right. Or we end up being pregnant by somebody that's already married and he can't do nothing for us. Right. Now it's drama. Now you as two sisters, now y'all got hatred for each other because you was the mistress and she the wife. Now she mad at you. You understand? This is happening in the black community all the time. God says, if you want to eliminate that from your life, read it again.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
Read.
A good understanding.
A good understanding of what the things that is going on in the world and the Bible is what? Read.
A good understanding have all they that do his commandments.
God said, follow my laws and you'll get understanding.
Right.
Black people die from one of the most hideous diseases out there. And we don't think nothing about it. Diabetes.
Right.
Diabetes is one of the worst diseases in the world.
Right.
And black people dying from it all over the world.
Right.
Why are we dying from diabetes, sister? Oh, Leviticus 11:7.
Really?
Why are we dying from diabetes, brother? Because we don't watch what we eat. So what are we supposed to be eating?
Don't supposed to be pork.
Uh-oh, look at this.
Bring it
I'm
out.
Telling you.
Chief.
Give me that real quick.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 11 and verse 7.
Listen to this, sister.
And the swine.
And the swine, that's the a swine, pig. That's read. Read.
Though he divide the hoof.
He got divided hooves, read.
And be cloven footed.
And his foot apart, stuff like that, that means cloven, read.
Yet he cheweth not the cud.
What that mean? He don't chew the cud. What that mean?
Oh, God.
Chew the cud is like what a cow do. You ever pass by a cow field and you just see them just out there chewing? They ain't eating nothing. They just chewing. And you say, why they just out there? But listen. Oh, that's good. That's a good thing, too. That's a good thing, too. Meat got sickness. But I'm just saying, when you look at a cow, though, that's something clean to eat. They have multiple chambers.
Right.
They swallow food, and they regurgitate
right,
it,
yeah,
and
exactly.
They chew it up, and it go to another chamber.
Right, exactly.
That's what it means by chew up the cud. Their anatomy is made for you to eat it,
right.
For it to be a clean animal.
Right.
The pig has the anatomy of garbage disposal.
Right.
The like you said, that trash can over there, God said that's what the pig is for the society.
Right.
When we let pigs run through Jackson, they'll eat up all the trash.
Yep.
This will be a clean. This actually be clean.
Right.
You ever see a dead, something die? Like a rodent or something get hit by a car, dog, what end up flying around? Vultures, buzzards.
Right.
And what end up happening when ain't no cars around? Them buzzards attack that dead meat because they are the garbage disposal of the sky.
Right.
God used them to clean up the goo. We don't need no trash man, really.
Right.
Oh, really?
God got trash animals to clean up the trash.
That's right.
But guess what we do? Guess what we do with the pig?
We
put it on the grill.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that poor top get. Red. Look at that. Woo, that thing look good. We eating that and we dying from it at an alarming rate. And when you get the wisdom of God,
right.
God said, if you get wisdom, if you follow this law, you get understanding. You'll understand this is why black people dying.
Right.
Because we eating what
high
God tell us not to eat. This is why high blood pressure is in our community.
Yes.
Gout. You know, they say high blood pressure. So I heard somebody say high blood pressure was hereditary. Huh?
Oh,
hereditary? Uh-huh. So it don't matter if I work out, if I'm in good shape, I'm going to just automatically have high blood pressure because my mama had it. Does that make any sense? No. Eating bad is hereditary
right.
because we
right.
learn it from our mom and daddy.
Right.
It's called generational curses.
Right.
That's slave food.
Right.
God says in order to understand the Bible, to get wisdom, you can't eat the whole.
Right.
Chitlins, that's pig intestines. You know how they got to clean it? You know what they cleaning, right? The boo-boo. And our people eat it. That's all right. That's all right. Our people eating it. But God said we the greatest people on earth.
Right.
God said we the greatest people on earth. And we are eating this unclean animal that is destroying us. Now, guess what? Jesus Christ said he got a judgment for that. You know what I want, Isaiah?
Yes, sir.
Jesus Christ said when he come back, if he catch you eating pork, if you got pork in your belly, when Christ come back, watch what he say. Read.
This is the book of Isaiah.
Come back, Officer Dead.
Chapter 66. And verse 17.
Read.
They that sanctify themselves.
They that sanctify themselves. So sanctified. I'm sanctified in the Holy Ghost. I'm a Christian. And I got God on my side. Will you hear that BS in the church? Guess what God is saying right here. Watch what he said. Read.
They that sanctify themselves.
They said, I'm holier than thou. You ain't going to hurt me. I'm going to get the kingdom of heaven. Read.
And purify themselves.
And purify themselves. Read. Saying that they just so holy and purified. Read. They clean. Read.
In the gardens. Behind one tree in the midst.
Because back then, we used to hold our congregation in the wilderness sometimes, in the garden, and behind the trees. So he's being symbolic of church. He's saying that if they doing this in the church, read.
Eating swine's flesh.
He said they eating swine's flesh in the church. Because that's what they do in the church. They sell us swine's flesh. They give us pig feet.
Right.
Hog maw, hog lips. And that's destroying our black bodies because we the children of Israel.
Yes.
We are God's chosen people and we eat defiled food like animals.
Right.
Read.
And the abomination.
Read.
And the mouse.
Read.
Shall
the mouse
be.
That's going into your possum. People, black folks love possum and armadillos. We eating the scum of the earth. We eating rats, man.
Right.
Read. Cool. Read.
Shall be consumed together, saith the Lord.
So God says if we eat those things, sister and brother, we're going to be consumed together. What does he mean by that? Read 15. That's what I wanted.
Isaiah chapter 66 and verse 15.
Because this is what our people do not care about. We only care about getting what we want right here in life right now, but that comes with a price.
Right.
If you can sacrifice what you're doing in your life that feels good to your body, but it's not good for your spirit, if you sacrifice that for God, you'll get the kingdom.
Right.
But if you continue to fight God to do your own lust, we're going to continue to be in the condition we're in today.
Right.
Read what you got.
For behold, the Lord will come with fire.
Christ is coming with fire. Read, that's the nuclear bombs. Read.
and with his chariots.
And with his chariots. You've been seeing all these, have you been seeing all these UFOs? You've been seeing all these and people talking about they seeing spaceships. Those are God's chariots.
Right.
Those are not aliens in there.
Right.
Those are black angels in there.
Right.
Read it again.
For behold, the Lord will come with fire.
Christ coming with fire.
And with his chariots.
And with his chariots, those spaceships, read.
Like a whirlwind.
Because they spin like this, read.
To render his anger with
fury. Because Christ is angry. He said he coming to render his anger. You know why he angry?
This is why he angry.
This is why Christ angry. Because we have been oppressed.
Right.
Because they killing us in an alarming rate.
They putting
coronavirus in our neighborhoods. They putting drugs in our neighborhoods. They putting us up on auction block. This look just like the NFL combine, don't it? When they had a black man stand up half naked so they can measure his body fat. I played in the league, I know. They used to have me standing up butt naked in some damn tights trying to measure my body fat and my height.
Serious?
Yes, the white man wanna know how high you jump. How much fat you got on your body? How tall you is? How long your arms is? How much you weigh? He want to know all that. He is infatuated with our body.
Right.
You understand? Go ahead. Read. Don't worry about that. Y'all
and
stay here. Long as y'all right here, y'all safe.
Right. And his
long as y'all here, y'all safe. Y'all got the angels encamped around. You can't see them, but they're here.
Right.
Read.
And his rebuke.
They not around your pastor. They here though. Read.
Right. Right.
And his rebuke. With flames of fire.
Rebuke me in correction. Christ gonna have to correct this place. This place out of order. This whole world is out of order. It's destroyed. It's decimated. It's going into shambles. That's why you see economic crisis, disease. You do know the white man created the coronavirus.
That's right.
Oh, yeah.
He created that.
The Chinese people.
Right, but he created it. The white man created it. Dr. Anthony Fauci.
Yep.
He is the head doctor on coronavirus CDC, on the coronavirus task force.
Yep.
They did a patent in 2004, and coronavirus has been around since 2004.
That's right.
You understand that? So with that being said, he gave China money to develop it in their labs. It got too great for them, and they couldn't control it, and it got out. And it started destroying all the people of China, and then it came here to America. But America the one started. You love this country so much, but this country is set up to destroy God's people.
Right.
And to destroy this whole planet. You understand? Read what you got. Hold on, before you get there, I got to get one. Give me Revelation chapter 11. Watch this, y'all.
God.
Revelation chapter 11. Let's read verse 19. I'm going to show you something.
Revelation.
Because I made a mention of something. I said that the white man is destroying the earth. Let's see what the Bible says. Read.
The book of Revelation. Chapter 11 and verse 19. And the temple of God was open in heaven.
Chapter 18.
Verse 18. And the nations were angry.
You know why they're going to be mad in that day? You know why the white man going to be mad, the Chinese man, the Arab man? You know why they're going to be mad when Christ comes? Because they're going to see us delivered, and they're going to have to endure the hell on earth like we done had to endure. So now he's saying what? Read it again.
And the nations were angry.
And they're going to get pissed off. Read.
And thy wrath is come.
And Christ gonna come with his wrath. We just read it. Read.
And the time of the dead that they should be judged.
Read.
And that thou shouldest give reward unto thy servants, the prophets.
That's what we out here for. Because we want to teach our people to get our people out of this hell so we can get our reward, which
is
the kingdom of God.
That's
read.
Right.
And to the saints and them that fear thy name.
That's what we trying to get. Read.
Small and great.
Read.
And shouldest destroy them which destroy the earth.
Don't you realize these cars destroy the earth? Don't you realize him creating all these bridges, destroying all these, plate tectonics?
Right.
Him putting all these chemicals in the air, him putting them 5G towers around. That's why he disguises them like trees. Because he know it destroys the atmosphere. Radiation destroys the atmosphere. That gives people cancer. When you stand too out and get too much radiation, you are susceptible to cancer.
Right.
He's destroying this planet.
Right.
And God said, I got to destroy him. Read it again. Read it again.
And from the top.
Read it, not from the bottom. They're destroying. I'm going to destroy them.
And should it destroy them which destroy the earth.
The white man is destroying this planet.
Right.
The Arab man is destroying this planet. You understand? So God said he gonna have to destroy them for what the evil that they're doing. So now, let's get 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 18 real quick.
Let me
show you about us. So where we fit in the mix? Where we at in the mix? Let me show you this real quick about us. Read. Read.
That's the book of 1 Peter chapter 4 and verse 18.
I think it's 17. Start at 17.
Verse 17. For the time is come.
The time is come right now. Read.
That judgment must begin at the house of God.
Who is the house of God? Who is the house of God? Who do you think? Okay. Matthew 15:24. We'll come back.
Bring it up.
The Bible real simple when you taught it the right way. We ought to, remember we read earlier that remember what he said earlier about the so-called white man that's in Israel calling himself a Jew. Remember God said he the synagogue of Satan. Synagogue is like a temple or worship. God said he the house of Satan.
Right.
But let me show you who we are. Read what you got.
The book of Matthew.
Watch this,
chapter
15.
Listen to this. And verse 24.
Come on.
But he answered and said, I am not sent, but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
So who is the house of God? The Israelites.
That's right.
Read that last precept. Read that last precept again. The house of what?
Of the house of Israel.
So we the house of Israel. We the house of God right now. Can you read what you got? Go back to 1 Peter 4:17. Now you're gonna understand what God's saying. Read.
The book of 1 Peter 4:17.
Come on.
For the time has come that judgment must begin at the house of God.
So when God judged these other nations, before he do that, he gonna judge this nation right here. God gonna deal with us first. You know why God gonna deal with us first? I'm gonna show you. Hold your finger there at 1 Peter. Get Isaiah 43:21. Real quick.
Now,
this is the house of God. This is who God gonna judge first. Read what you got.
The book of Isaiah.
This is how God gonna judge us, y'all. Read.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 43 and verse 21.
This is why God gonna judge us first. Read.
This people have I formed for myself.
Because God made us for him. He made us to be close to him.
Right.
He chose us to be the greatest nation. He gave us commandments to govern this earth.
Right.
But we said, we don't want to govern the earth, Lord. We want to be like the white woman.
Right.
We want to put blonde in our hair like her. We want our hair straight like her. We want to put raccoon hair in our head like hers.
Right.
So God said, okay, you want to be like the white woman? All right, well, let me put the white man over y'all then. Yeah. Oh, you want to be like the white man and shave your beard and look like a baby? All right, let me put him over you then.
Bring it up.
Every time we go and try to do what they do, God is saying this. Read it again.
These people have I formed for myself.
Read.
They shall show forth my praise.
He said, they shall show forth my praise. It is what it is. We say this. This is how they're going to be saved. Y'all two brothers and sisters, somebody might lie on y'all and say, you was at such and such house shooting somebody or robbing somebody. But you hear what? That's why we got the camera out here. It's a time stamp. No, she wasn't. She was with us. No, he wasn't. He was with us.
Right.
So don't be ashamed of that. We got to use it. We got to show what's going on here.
Right.
Read what you got, bro.
1 Peter.
Go back to 1 Peter. So he said he formed us for himself to show forth his praise. That's you, because you're a Judite. You're a Judite too. Read.
1 Peter 4:17.
Read.
For the time has come that judgment must begin at the house of God.
But the thing is, God is going to first judge the house of God, which is the Israelites.
Right.
He's going to judge us first. Why? Read.
And if it first begin at us.
It's going to begin at us. Read.
What shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of God?
So wait a minute. God gonna deal with us first because we his chosen.
Right.
He set us over this entire planet.
That's right.
We said we didn't want to be over the planet. We wanted the white man to rule over us and the Chinese and the Arab.
Right.
And now they beating our brains in, shooting us down, and don't go to jail for it. God said, well, that's what y'all wanted. Y'all wanted to be like them.
Right.
Y'all didn't want to do what I said. Y'all wanted to be like them. Right. Read that, Deuteronomy 28:47.
Oh.
Let me show you one of the curses that God told us. God told us, look, y'all got me, what y'all need? We said, no, Lord. I want to be like them Africans.
Uh-huh.
I want to be like the Chinese.
Yep,
read what you got.
The book of Deuteronomy.
I
want to
be like Lang Ming.
Uh-huh.
The hell is this? Read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 47.
Come on.
Because thou servest not the Lord thy God.
So we didn't want to serve the Lord. He said, you don't want to serve me. Guess what? Read.
Because thou servest not the Lord thy God with joyfulness and with gladness of heart. For the abundance of all things.
God gave us everything. We ruled the earth. We didn't have to work for nothing. We didn't have to work for nothing. Now we got to work every single day just to make ends meet. Read.
Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies.
You see how God worked? God just like your dad. Oh.
Yeah, right.
Daddy told you not to do it, so you want to go ask mama behind daddy back. Well, come here and get a whooping. Right? And then what daddy do? That's what our daddy do. The God of heaven and earth. He said, you don't want to serve me? With joyfulness and gladness of heart, you're not happy to serve the one true God that saved you out of Egypt?
That's right.
So you don't want to serve me. So what did he say? Read.
Therefore, shalt thou serve thine enemies.
Si, you don't want to serve me, so guess what? I'm going to make you serve the white man.
Right. Yep.
And he going to beat your back in. He going to force you to pay taxes on every dollar you get.
Yep.
And he going to force you to pay gas, light, water, internet,
right.
Insurance. We got to have insurance on everything nowadays. Right. Here it is, you paying insurance for 40 years and never die.
Right.
I've been paying life insurance for 40 years and I don't die. You understand? And now for 40 years, they done got millions off of me. And when it's time for me to issue my policy, they say, you got the death certificate.
$10,000.
He died too close to the house.
Right. Or they'll say, oh, it was an act of God.
Right.
Oh, he died from the COVID-19? Uh-huh. Oh, that's not under our policy. We didn't say nothing about COVID-19.
Right.
They are destroying us. They are robbing us blind.
Right.
And the Bible telling us why it happened, because we don't want to serve God.
Right.
We want to serve them. Read.
Which the Lord shall send against thee.
Somebody get this sign for me real quick.
It said, which the Lord shall send against thee. What that mean?
We was on the west coast of Africa. God sent our enemies right to know where we was at.
Look at that.
They could have went to Central Africa. They could have went right here to get people. They could have got the little bitty 4'2" Chinese man. He ain't big and strong. But they came and got the biggest, strongest, mightiest nation on the west coast of Africa.
That's
now, how the hell they know we was there? Because God let them. Because God said, you don't want to serve me? Guess what? I'm going to send your enemies against you. And they're going to know exactly where you at. Because the whole continent of Africa is black people.
Right.
Why did they come and get the Israelites? Because God sent them. Because
right.
We cursed them for we disobedient to God. We got to come back to them.
Oh.
These Christian churches will never teach you that. Because
right.
If they teach you that, then now you got to question, is Christ black? Why y'all got the white Jesus in the background?
Oh,
I thought
Lord,
we were the Israelites.
God.
Now you got to add, now you got to question everything. And they can't answer.
Right.
They don't know the answer. Because you got
to
come out of them churches. You got to come and join the Israelites. Because
yeah,
that's who you are. Can't nobody break the Bible down and tell you who you are like the brothers in purple and gold.
Right.
Can't nobody do it. Read. And that's not us bragging or being boastful. We just trying to show our people that this is the way.
Right. That's right.
Keeping the commandments of God and the faith in Christ is how you're going to get the kingdom of heaven as an Israelite.
Right.
Continue to stand these Christian churches, Islam, Egyptology, black woman, God, all that stuff, that's going to get you destroyed, man.
Right.
Read.
Which the Lord shall send against thee.
So God sent our enemies against us. Read.
In hunger.
Read.
And in thirst.
Read.
And in nakedness.
And in nakedness. Read.
And in want of all things.
So guess what? Food, water, clothes. Those are the basic things that every brother and every woman need on this planet.
Right.
The Bible says you got to go to the white man to get that.
Right.
You got to go to the Arab man to get that. The Chinese, the Indonesian.
Right.
You got to go to them to get that.
Right.
Read.
And he shall put a yoke of iron.
Right here. Here you go. Right here. Deuteronomy chapter 28. What did it say? Deuteronomy 28:20-48. What did it say?
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck.
Who put yokes of iron on our neck with bells on it? So when we ran away from the plantation that night, they could hear us running in the woods. Who's jingle bell? That's where jingle bells come from. That song, jingle bells, come because they put it around our neck.
Bring it up.
They raped us, robbed us, and murdered us, and forced us to have chains and shackles to where our skin was starting to deteriorate.
Right.
And around our neck. Come on, man. It's time for us to learn the Bible, bro.
Right.
We ain't learned the Bible. Now people riding around here thinking they know something. You don't know nothing.
Ain't
you ain't been taught nothing, man. Right. Read it again.
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck until he have destroyed thee.
God said he going to put the yoke on your neck so he have destroyed you. Do we have yokes on our neck now? They not on our neck now.
Duh.
They gone. So what that mean? We destroyed.
That's right.
We destroyed. We don't know who we are.
Uh-huh.
The pastor can't answer no questions. The Islamic temple can't answer no questions.
Don't
what did it say? Don't ask.
Don't
no question. Don't ask. Just pass around the plate.
Yes.
Spend your money and I'll have answers for you.
That's right.
These people wicked as hell, man. I'm telling
don't
you.
Know your last name.
Why? Don't we don't know nothing, man. We destroyed out here, man. Now, go back to what I said. Go to Zephaniah 1:8 for the sister. So sis, you understand you got to wear dresses?
Yeah.
Right. So because you are a beautiful daughter of Sarah.
That's right.
And you got to teach you got daughters?
Or just
son? You got,
Two daughters and one son and one on the way.
Okay, I'll pray to the Most High. I got three daughters, so I know how it is. We must teach our daughters to wear dresses to cover their body. Because they are being used as merchandise in America.
Right.
Because let's be honest. The black woman got a certain build. She's endowed differently from everybody else on
the
earth.
Beautiful.
Right.
And she's a beautiful woman.
Right.
So America has now used our black women as merchandise. That's why they got them twerking half naked, getting a million views on Instagram.
Yep.
They're doing that to exploit your body. That's why you go down here. I used to be in Black Diamonds, wicked as hell. I changed my life, all praise. But I used to be in that too. V-Live, all that. I used to be doing all that wickedness.
Right.
But we throwing money at our daughters as if they dirt and trash.
Then we trying to whisper in their ear saying, hey, you know you can go meet tonight. I got the most money. Me and my boys having a party.
Bring it up.
That's the mindset we have become.
Bring it up.
We have become degenerate. Degenerate means decayed, destroyed. Right. That's what we've become. Read y'all got?
Yes, sir.
Zephaniah 1 and 8. This is what God said about if we don't dress correctly.
Right.
Oscar K.S., come.
This is the book of Zephaniah, chapter 1 and verse 8. And it shall come to pass in the day of the Lord's sacrifice that I will punish the princes and king's children.
The princes and the king's children, read.
And such as are clothed with strange apparel.
Did you hear that, sis? And such, read again. And such.
And such as are clothed with strange apparel.
God calls that strange apparel because he told the woman to wear the dress. So when if he comes back and our women are out of order.
Right.
Read it again.
Get up.
And such.
And such as are clothed with strange apparel.
That apparel is strange to God. Right. Mm. Mm. Any more now?
Lord,
you see it? Yeah, go ahead.
This is the book of 1 Timothy. Chapter 2 and verse 9.
Now we're fixing to discuss how we are to dress as a woman, right?
Read.
In like manner also, that women adorn themselves in modest apparel.
Adorn themselves in modest apparel. That's why we're talking about the dresses. Now, we don't want a skin tight dress. That's not modest. You know, you got to wear a loose dress.
Right.
And one below the knees, on down to the ankle. Right? That's modest. Read.
With shamefacedness and sobriety.
That's just going into not all up in a man's face. You know, she should stay back and stay quiet. Read.
Not with broidered hair or gold or pearls or costly array.
Right.
But which becometh women professing godliness.
But becoming professing godliness. We gotta get the understanding of the words of God. We gotta come back to his law. That's what it's going into. We got to come back to God's laws because we will be destroyed for leaving God's law.
Right.
That's destruction. He's going to bring destruction on us. So the question should be, what do we need to do then? Right? That should be the question because the officers have taught a lot up here today.
Right.
So we should have questions like, so now what can I do now? What can I do about this now? Yeah. About this that I'm learning. The Bible tells all that. Let's get Hosea 5:15 right quick.
Read up.
Because see, God has allowed these nations to bring in this COVID-19, to do all this wickedness to us.
Right.
Do all this wickedness to us, right?
Right.
So where's God? Uh-oh. Let's read this.
The book of Hosea.
Come on.
Chapter 5 and verse 15.
Uh-huh.
I will go and return to my place.
God said, I will go and return to my place. Because they so hard-headed. I'm going to go return to my place. Read.
Till they acknowledge their offense.
Until they acknowledge that they have offended me. We've offended God. We don't want to offend God. That's God. Read.
And seek my face.
We got to seek his face. We've offended him and now he has left us. We got to seek his face. And that's what y'all doing today. That's what you said. You came out here. You were looking for what was right. Because you knew what you were getting was wrong. So you seeking his face. So now we got to go another step. We got to go another step. We got to continue to seek his face.
Right.
We got to seek his face till he gets back here.
That's right.
Read.
In their affliction, they will seek me early.
We're being afflicted now. COVID-19. Stay in your house.
That's it.
Shot down in the streets.
Bring it out.
We're being afflicted now.
Right.
So now we look. Now this is wrong. Ain't nobody teaching me nothing. I got to go find the people that's got the truth of this Bible.
Yes.
So you're seeking now. You in your affliction now. You're seeking him early now.
Right.
Read. Go to 1 Kings 8:47.
Read up.
Because this is what we got to do now. Now that he's gone to his place, we've got to acknowledge our offense.
Right.
And this is what we've got to do.
This is the book of 1 Kings, chapter 8 and verse 47.
Come on.
Yet, if they shall bethink themselves.
If they shall bethink themselves, meaning remember who you are. Because we forgot who we are. They got us over here calling us African American. We call each other that. With
That's
pride.
Right.
With pride.
Right.
We're proud of that.
That's
because
right.
We don't even know who we are.
That's right.
Read.
In the land whither they were carried captives.
How did we get over here? Did he show you earlier? How did we get
boat.
Over here?
On the boat.
On slave ship.
Thank you.
Read that again.
Yet if they shall bethink themselves.
Remember who you are.
In the land whither they were carried captives.
We were carried captive into this land. Read.
And repent.
We got to repent. That's the key. It's not over when we learn who we are. We've got to repent. See, it's not over. Just I'm going home tonight. I learned so much tonight. I just feel so much better. But the Bible says we've got to repent.
That's right. That's right.
We got to repent. So now we got to figure out, what does that mean? What does it mean to repent? Because I thought I had already repented. I was in church. Right? I thought I had repented. Read the rest of that.
And make supplication unto thee in the land of them that carried them captive, saying, we have sinned.
That's what we got to say. We have sinned.
That's right.
And he was showing you what sin is earlier. What is sin? Do you know what sin is? Because we're going to come back here.
Bring it up.
You know what sin is? What is sin? We've been to church all these years. We should know. We should at least know what sin is. We go to church because of sin, right?
Yeah.
But we don't even know what sin is. And the message we gotta tell him. Does that make any sense? What is sin? We can't even answer that, honestly.
That is really
sin. It's in the Bible, though. It's in the Bible, though, but the pastors are not gonna teach you this in the Bible. Let's see what sin is. Read.
The book of 1 John, chapter 3 and verse 4.
Read.
Whosoever committeth sin transgresseth also the law.
It says, whosoever committed sin transgress also the law. Transgress means to break God's laws. So whoever is sinning is breaking God's laws.
Right.
So if a woman, if God says for the woman to not wear what pertains to a man, and she's in pants, she's breaking God's law.
Right.
Read.
For sin is the transgression of the law.
Right.
Sin is breaking God's law. That's what sin is. God gave the laws to the Israelites.
That's right.
That's who we are. That's who we are. Don't run from the truth, brother. Don't run from the truth. Don't run from the truth. Bring them on over here. Come on. Come on over here and get some of this.
That's right.
Bring it.
That's what you need.
That's right.
What you need is over here. Anyway, sis. Are you getting this, sis? Read that again.
1 John chapter 3 and verse 4. Whosoever committed sin. Transgresseth also the law.
Right. Transgressing the law. Breaking God's laws. We got to stop breaking God's laws.
Right.
That's why these curses are on us. That's why they own us. And our only way out is to come back to God. We got to repent.
Right.
We got to repent and keep God's commandments. Now, let's go to Acts and get repent.
Yes, sir.
Let's go there. Because let's talk about repentance for a minute. Because we're talking about keeping God's laws. We got to repent, sister. That's what we're going to have to do. So let's find out what that's talking about. Okay?
This is the book of Acts, chapter 3 and verse 19.
Read.
Repent ye therefore and be converted.
It says repent and be converted. Repent and be converted. Read.
That your sins may be blotted out.
That your sins may be blotted out. That your sins may be blotted out, right?
When the times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord.
Right. Now let's go to Psalms.
19:7.
That's what I want.
Bring it up.
It says be converted. So we got to find out, what does it mean to be converted? What converts us? If we got to be converted, that means something can convert us. And it's in the Bible. This is where we got to go. Go ahead and read it.
The book of Psalms, chapter 19 and verse 7.
Read.
The law of the Lord is perfect.
These laws that we have been bringing out. Woman wear the dress. Right. Man wear the pants. Man don't shave your beard out. Don't cut into your beard.
Right.
These laws that we've been bringing out, these laws are perfect. You say you got kids? Well, you got rules in the house. You tell your kids, the rules you got in the house are perfect for your kids, right?
Right.
You're not going to tell your kid to put your hand on that hot oven. You're going to say, don't get close to that oven.
That's right.
Those laws are perfect in your house for your kids.
Right.
God's laws are perfect in this earth for us.
That's right.
But we run from the law.
Right.
We listen to the other nation.
Right.
Read.
The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul.
The law is what converts the soul. Remember in Acts it said, be ye converted, repent and be converted. The laws is what converts us. When we begin to keep God's laws, that's the beginning of conversion.
Right.
We got to get converted. We've got to change.
Right.
No matter what anybody else thinks about it.
Right.
We've got to do that. And everybody personally has to do that.
That's right.
You can't repent for your children.
That's right.
But you can repent and teach your children.
Right. Bring it up.
Right? You see that? Read that one more time. I got to hear that again. Read
Psalm
that again.
19 and verse 7.
Come on.
The law of the Lord is perfect.
The law of the Lord is perfect. Remember that. Read.
Converting the soul.
And that's what's going to convert your soul. And that's the only thing that's going to convert your soul. So you understand why the people in the, what church did you go to? A Baptist church?
New Arrival.
Is that Baptist?
No, they're Christian.
A Christian church. Okay, all of them same. But
right.
But the point is. But
right,
yeah,
that right.
The point is, are they converted?
No.
Go ahead.
What church you said that was? You talking about that big old church on Ellis?
Yeah.
New Horizon?
That's how they walk. Damn.
You want the blessings of God? Christian, they're not yours because of the work of Jesus. No. Tithe! Give money and you'll get the blessing. If you don't, nothing for you. What has happened to the gospel of grace? These charlatans have turned it into a gospel of works. And they have put people, wow, have they put people under bondage. This is one of the most disturbing things you might ever see.
I bet I'll walk on this money. Woo! 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 Get some anointing. You put somebody up. Woo! Man. Woo! Put some money. Put some anointing on this money. You put something up here. You put. Woo! Prosper. Prosper, I said.
You want your bills paid? Throw money at their feet so they can dance in it. What do you know? It's a prosperity gospel with a string attached. That string is works, and that means it's no gospel at all. Wow.
I had to answer myself.
You see? Dang. You see, they're all up in it, but a lot of those are our brothers and sisters that need to come out just like you're doing right now.
That's right.
But you gotta stay on this journey. You can't just come out here tonight and get a feel good.
That's right.
And a dance.
Bring it up.
And then go home. You gotta get that flyer, you gotta get that number, you gotta give us a call.
That's right.
You got to come and learn. It's a whole lot more than that Bible.
Bring it up.
You're not even getting a snippet of what's in this Bible.
Right.
You see that? So you got to use that. You gotta use that. Our wives and all of our sisters are with us. They are always in the school taking care of their part of it. So the woman's got a part in the church, right?
That's right.
Woman's got a part in the church. So you need to continue after. You make sure you use that number.
Oh, I can't remember what to do.
And the website, yeah. Make sure you get in touch with us, so that you can come and visit with us, right? We on Terry Road. It's on the address on that paper right there.
We used to scream Black Power while Heron was pushed, but at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.